Good evening everyone. So as promised in the previous video that we will be simulating steam engine. Before starting this tutorial, I would request to please watch video number 1 and video number 2 to have basic understanding regarding various unit operations which we have simulated in previous two videos: pumps, heaters, cooler, compressor, valve. We have already simulated these equipment in previous two videos. Now, what is the objective of our today's simulation? That to learn to how to simulate a steam engine and how to simulate pump, heater, cooler and turbine. In the previous videos, we haven't learned how to simulate a turbine. So this will be an additional equipment which we'll learn today how to simulate it. Now, what is a flow sheet? Water at 25 degrees centigrade and 1.013 bar is pumped to the boiler at 60 bar. This is the pump. The water is entering the pump and exiting the pump, entering the pump at 25 degrees centigrade and 1.013 bar and exiting the pump at 60 bar. In the boiler, superheated steam is produced. For our simulation, we will take heater as boiler, where we will provide Q heat. Superheated steam is produced in the boiler at 450 degrees centigrade and 59 bar. Entering at 60 bar, exit at 450 degrees centigrade and 60 bar. This HP steam then produces work in turbine, which is labeled as K100. You can also name it as turbine. The steam produces work in the turbine and saturated steam exit the turbine at 3 bar. The saturated steam is condensed to saturated liquid in the condenser. Similarly, we will use cooler to carry out the condensation operation. For evaporation, for superheating purpose, we are using the heater, and for reverse operation, which is the condensation, we are using the cooler over here. The water leaves the condenser at 25 degrees centigrade and 1 bar. So this is the whole schematic. Obviously, we will again, like the other videos, we have used 100 kg per hour, but this time we will be using 100 kg mole per hour for our system. So let's start. As I have said, click the new button. Add the component list. We have already explained it and learned it in our video number 1. Then in fluid package, as I have told you earlier, that this is a power related task. So for power industries, we use Peng-Robinson or SRK as our property package. Peng-Robinson, and it has turned green, which means we have selected the right property package. Simulation environment. First, we select pump, as the information given is that water at 25 degrees centigrade and 1.013 bar is pumped to the boiler. So we will click pump, place it over here. First, we will do its connections. W1, it's my nomenclature, you can use your own nomenclature. W2, and since work is required, W1. These must be different from each other. So we have to first enter the specifications of W1, which is our material stream. This W1 is the energy stream. This W1 is the material stream. So 25 degrees centigrade, 1.013 bar and 100 kg mole per hour. And then we have to enter the composition, which is the mole composition. And since it's water, so it will be 1. If it's more than one component, then in the last video we have also learned we can use different composition. Like for methane, ethane, we use 0.5 and 0.5. So we will just press OK. Now it's asking unknown duty. So those of you who have watched the video number 1 will understand that we can either enter unknown duty if we are given the duty, or we can enter the outlet pressure. So we know the outlet pressure, which is 60 bar. So we will enter it, and it's converts. It means the degree of freedom of pump is 1. Because it requires just one outlet parameter to converge. Make sure that the button over here is active. If it's on hold, the simulation won't converge and you will be worried what's happening. You are giving the right value. Click active and this simulation will, so this equipment will converge and your simulation will run. Now, superheated steam is pumped to the boiler at 60 bar. Superheated steam is produced in the boiler at 450 degrees centigrade and 59 bar. So as I have said earlier, we will be using heater as boiler in the system. Just click heater. Now the outlet of pump is inlet of boiler. W2, W3, and W-2, just like the other one. So here it's asking for two parameters. It means the degree of freedom is 2. If we do not enter two parameters, then it will be underspecified. And if we enter more than two parameters, obviously that you can do when it's on hold, then it will not converge. It will say it's over specified. So you can check it as well. So it's 450 degrees centigrade and 59 bar, as I have told you. Superheated steam is produced in the boiler at 450 degrees centigrade and 59 bar. So this is how heater is converged. After that, the steam produces work in the turbine and saturated steam exit or leaves the turbine at 3 bar. So the next one is turbine, and you can see here in fifth row expander, which is a turbine basically. So outlet of boiler is inlet of turbine or expander. So you can say W3 and W4 is outlet and W-3. Again, I would say you can use your own nomenclature. You can say it as E1, E2, E3, E4, it's up to you. So what's the given task? What's the given information? The steam produces work in the turbine and saturated steam leaves the turbine at 3 bar. So we will enter 3, and you can see it's converged, it's simulated, means its degree of freedom is 1. And it's works same like that of compressor, where degree of freedom is 1, where you have to enter the pressure. Next task is to install a condenser where condensation takes place, where the saturated steam condenses to saturated liquid. So the saturated steam is condensed to saturated liquid in the condenser. So we will install cooler over here. As you can see here, the inlet of the cooler is outlet of the turbine, and outlet of the cooler is inlet of the pump. So it's very easy to simulate. You have to just do the connections. What is outlet of turbine? W4. What is outlet of condenser? That is inlet of pump. That is W1 over here. So we'll just enter W1, just give an energy stream name W-4, and you will see it's automatically converged because you have already entered the specification of W1. So that's how a steam engine is simulated in Aspen Plus. We can change the names as well. You can say it P100 to pump. Going into the connection, name, change the pump. Similarly, click here, go to design, name, boiler. Similarly, design, turbine, and click here, that is condenser. So that's how you can simulate a steam engine. Now, total work produced, how we can calculate it? It can be calculated by total power in minus total power out. Total power produced. Turbine is producing power. Pump is consuming power. So the difference between W3 and W1 will give you value of total power produced in this system. So click on W3, it will give you an answer of 2.196 raised to power 10 multiplied by 10 raised to power 5 kilocalories per hour. And click here 3362 kilocalories per hour. So just subtract these two terms to calculate what actual power this steam engine is producing. So that's all from today's simulation task. Next time we will simulate the refrigeration cycle. Please do watch the video Please do share your feedback regarding the video in the comment section. Please do like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you so much.